Yo, what's up YouTube? This is a safety alert video. You know, I was browsing through Instagram and I saw a post where a driver got missing, and after some time of searching, the driver was found dead in his Toyota Corolla, the Uber driver in K2 Axis in Lagos. So I just want to sound this as a reminder, a quick reminder, when it comes to safety and doing ride sharing in whichever city you find yourself. Well, let's say for example Lagos, you know, please avoid going to places you are not familiar with, especially at night. We don't exactly know the full story of what happened to this guy, because they said he was found dead in the car with blood in the passenger side of his vehicle. And his car was not stolen. It's a Toyota Corolla. So if the car was stolen, we'll say, okay, maybe the car was the target of the whole attack. But the car was not stolen. The car was left at the scene where the thing happened. So probably he got into an argument with the rider, and probably the rider had a weapon, you know, maybe stabbed him or did something bad to him and left him dead. Avoid going to places you're not familiar with, because it may be that maybe hoodlums even attacked him in the vehicle, because one of his windows, one of his glass was shattered. They say one of his car windows was shattered. It may be he got into a struggle with some hoodlums. So avoid going to places you're not familiar with. Just if you drive, if you are a full-time driver or you drive part-time, you would know some dynamics in some places. Like somewhere like, let's say, Agege, Ijora, Lokba, all those kind of places, Maitu, you know, those places are very, you know, very volatile places when it comes to violence and danger. So avoid those kind of places at night. You know, avoid going to places, those kind of places when you know the traffic will be very high. You know, that can also, you know, make you stay in that kind of place into the night. And also try to close on time. See me now, I'm home. This is just past 4 and I'm home. Although, why am I home? I did about 2 trips that was worth it. I did like 2 very long trips. So I just be like, okay, I've done 2 long trips. So what am I saying? I'm stressed out already. Like I've drove, the first long trip was about 2 hours journey, you know, because of traffic though. Then the second one was about almost 2 hours journey from Surulere to somewhere around Songo. The third one was from around Songo back to Surulere. So I think I'm done. I've already been on the road. If you add us up, if you add all that up together, it will be about 6-7 hours of driving. So what am I still looking for? And if you ask me, I've met my target for the day in terms of monetary level. So what am I doing out late in the evening again when the traffic is so high? I've already dealt with the traffic in the morning. So why am I still going to be out again to deal with the traffic in the evening? So I just say, let me come home. So try to come home on time. Like my friend would always say, AY, as in it's best for you to do this ride sharing like a 9-to-5. What it meant is, leave your house, as in when you go home, when you are setting out for the day, at least set out in the time where you know a lot of people are going to office. Forget about the early morning rush. Stop waking up early morning. It's not healthy for you. I'm telling you, you need that extra sleep to boost your energy level. At least sleep between the hours of five, six. Please just be in your house, sleep, take your shower, you know, do some little exercise, relax. Then set out maybe 7:38. Between set out before 9. Then all the way through, you can have lunch break between the hours of 12, 1, 2. You can just take a chill, relax. Or between the hours of 12 and 1, relax. Then continue working again. And once it's getting to like 4, 5, 6, before the sun down, please start finding your way home. Let other drivers deal with the evening rush and everything and the evening traffic. You try to go home in a reasonable time. Try to go home on time. Driving into the night is not safe anymore. The crime rate is alarming. It's crazy. Different things is happening in the city of Lagos. I don't know which city you are. I know different things are happening all over the world right now. People are desperate to make money, and you know, crazy things are just happening. So just try to go home on time. At least it's not like if you go home on time, people that stay go home on time are totally immune from danger. But at least you take yourself out of that possibility of things, the bad things that happen in the night to happen to you. So just try to go home on time. Set out in a reasonable time of the day and try to go home on time. Another very important thing is you need to have a tracker in your car. Install a tracker in your car. If this guy had a tracker in his car, they wouldn't have to look for him for so long. So if the guy had a tracker in his car, he would have been seen, you know, faster. Maybe the next day or that night they didn't see him, he didn't come home throughout the night. But somebody that had access to his tracker, is of course, when you have a tracker in your car, not just you will have access to track your car, at least maybe your next of kin or somebody you trust should also have access to track your vehicle. So they would have probably text the number or get the command to get his location, you know, and track his vehicle. And most likely when they find him on time, if he had a tracker, he would have had a chance to leave. So have a tracker in your car. And about tracker, I have a physical tracker now on ground and I'm willing to sell. It's a comprehensive tracker. It has SOS panic button, where when you click the button, it calls the number, it gives the number. The number in the tracker flashes the numbers that you install in the tracker. You know, like you just press the button and it gives you SOS alert. Maybe there's danger, you just, you know, quickly press it. So if you're interested in buying that tracker, you can hit me up on buzzydriver.ng@gmail.com. If you're interested in buying the comprehensive car tracker, so I'll reply you. Just say you need the tracker and I'll reply you. I can, you know, deal. Another thing you need in your car that will, you know, give you a form of safety is a dash cam. You know, while I started ride sharing, when I had a dash cam in my car, but I sold that car and I sold it with the dash cam. So right now, I've been browsing through all the dash cam options available and I've not made up my mind on the particular one to buy. But guys, you need a dash cam. It is very, very, very important that you have a dash cam in your car. If this guy had a dash cam in his car, well considered dash cam. There's some dash cam that are coded. You know, people don't exactly know what is happening in the dash cam. It should just be there, like, just, you don't have to be very conspicuous as a dash cam. If you have such dash cam, it records everything in your car without the passenger feeling, you know, threatened that is under surveillance. You know, if any crime happen or anything happen, God forbid, if they know there's a dash cam in the car, they can easily just take out the dash cam and destroy it. But this is concealed, you know, have a concealed dash cam, you know, where you can play back video things that happen in your car, video evidence. Many drivers have been deactivated because of word of mouth accusation. Somebody that accused them of something and they were deactivated. So that's another advantage of you having a dash cam. So those are the few points when it comes to safety. And of course, when your intuition is telling you that this ride is not going to end well, please just cancel the trip and, you know, move on. No matter how long the distance is, no matter how the surge on the trip, when your mind tells you, I'm not comfortable with these guys in my car, I'm not comfortable with these people in my car, just end the trip and, you know, look for another trip. Let another person deal with them. So always follow your intuition. Your intuition is very strong. Follow it. It's not easy, man. Imagine somebody going out to try to get something to eat, as in try to make money for his family, you know, try to make money for his upkeep, and he ended up, you know, being killed. This is sad. And yes, I forgot to add, last but not the least, guys, honestly, you guys, we all need something like a self-protective device, self-defense device. I'm sure you guys know what this is. This delivers about almost how many, this thing, if it touch you, if this thing touch you, can you guys see it? Can you hear it? At least have a self-defense device. If it's a taser gun and a pepper spray. I used to have a pepper spray. One policeman just stole my pepper spray. He stole my pepper spray from me. A policeman stole my pepper. That's what we have in Nigeria. Policemen that steal. They're not here to defend us. They're not here to protect us. They're here to steal from us and extort us. Have one of these. If you're interested in having one of these taser and pepper spray, you can send me a message, email, and say self-defense device. Just write self-defense device and we'll continue the conversation from there. And I'll give you the plug how you can get some of this kind of stuff. And yes, it's legal to have it. It's not a firearm. It's legal to have it. So that's the last point. I just remembered I had to come back to quickly do that. Let me head back inside. So guys, remember to like this video, subscribe for more, and, you know, be safe out there. Peace.